Hi everyone! Today I want to show you the level 60 White Mage quest in from Heavensward. We are here in the Black Shroud, South Shroud at Camp Tranquil, and we have to talk to Raya Osenna. But before I want to show you the gear I am wearing, I bought the item level 255 normal gear at the Javeled Crozier in Ishgard. There you can even buy now the level 60 accessories. Item level 255. Let's talk to Raya Osenna. Hands of Healing. And we get attire coffer with item level 200 gear, when I'm right. And a new command, Tetragrammaton. Okay. Restores targets HP, cure potency 700, cast instant, recast 60 seconds, radius 0 yam, range 30 yam. Raya O would call a meeting to discuss measures against the taint. Sweet. We have conceived a plan to deal with the taint. We would share the particulars with everyone. Might I trouble you to fetch a Shiva? She will have returned to Fall God Float, I believe. Pray, return her after you have notified her. Arun and I shall be waiting. God Float. Oh, it's you, sweet. I must apologize for my earlier display. The Cetius wish to see me despite the disrespect I showed them, so their ways baffle me. It cannot be denied that they care for the forest. Perhaps they deserve more credit than I give them. I will go, of course. Let us strike out at once. Let's go back to Camp Tranquil. Our thanks for coming. Without further ado, let us begin. After our last meeting, I went to the Guardian Tree and presented the Taint Flesh to the Great One. His reaction was telling. The befouled ether it bears is identical to the Taint which now threatens the Dwarfswood. Unless we stop Alacqua, the forest will be reduced to a wasteland of death. Sweet gave me to understand that you have conceived a plan to deal with the taint. What is the plan? Simply put, Arun and I shall accompany you to the Trevanian Forelands. As you are doubtless aware, the Pajars are chosen by the elementals to convey their will. Should that will go unheard or be misinterpreted, harmony would be lost and tragedy inevitably befall. In order to prevent this, we strive to own our sensitivity to the elementals far beyond the limits of ordinary men. and this sensitivity allows us to perceive even the slightest fluctuations in the ether. With our faculty for sensing ether, Arun and I shall ascertain the site of Alakwa's experiment. And once we find it, we will join our powers to Sweets and purge the taint once and for all. You would leave the forest? But what of the will of the elementals? Rest assured, we have obtained the Elder Cecil's permission. Our sister shall see to it that the elementals do not go unheard during our absence. But above all, your words struck home. We will not leave the two of you to bear the burden alone. We shall do all we can to aid you, as Pajars and White Mage spouse. You truly mean to leave the forest and help us? In the heat of the moment, I forgot myself and spoke out of turn. I pray you can forgive me. There's not to forgive. On the contrary, we are grateful to you for opening our eyes. Now I trust we can rely upon you to guide the way. Listen, sweet. This will be our first time outside the forest, and we will most certainly make fools of ourselves. I would thank you not to enjoy yourself overmuch. I shall escort the Cecius to Tailfeather. Pray meet us there. Let's go to Tailfeather now. So, here we are at Tailfeather. Why, the journey here wasn't nearly as daunting as I expected. I dare say we could have made it without a Shiva. Bold words coming from someone who fairly hugged our guide during the entire journey. Seeing as we are here, we ought to get to work. Do you sense anything, brother? I do, an anomaly in the ether that wrenches the stomach. It emanates from the north and west. A cavern lies in that direction, Morn this called, and if memory serves, so too does a water vein. It seems to me that is where we must go. I must warn you all, though, that the area is thick with dragons. We must proceed with caution. Dragons, you say? Well, I for one would welcome to excitement. The journey thus far has been rather dull for my tastes. Dull suits us just fine, sister. Remember, our priority is to purge the taint. As if I would forget. The fate of the Dwarfswood is at stake. Let us make haste to Morn and confront Alakwa. We have to go there. higher. So it's an instanced fight we have. Okay. Then we are prepared and talk to Alacqua. Duty calls commence battle for hands of healing. If your level is above 60, it will be synced. We are 60. So, you are still alive. Most intriguing horns such as I have, yet you are not, Aura. Well, whatever you are no different from the others. You have come to interfere with my experiment, but know this. It is your ignorance that has led us down this path. We Xaela are nomads who roam and live off the land. My tribe was no different, yet so we did no harm to those whose lands we traversed. They treated us as vermin. In their ignorance, they feared us, and that fear manifested as spite and violence. My loved ones and I were cursed, My loved ones and I were cursed at, spat upon, beaten, and worse. It was out of the desire to protect them that I began my research. Such pain we have suffered. I swore that I would visit upon the ignorant masses 100-fold. And soon I shall fulfill my goal, for my experiment has finally borne fruit. To be sure, there is still work to be done. Such robust flesh cannot be sustained by ordinary ether. Nay, it must needs be fed something far more potent, the taint. My pet can go only where this taint exists, and so I shall fill the whole world with it. Sister, I sense naught but befouled ether from the dragon. This is without a doubt the source of the taint. We must needs purify it whole. You would get in the way of my vengeance. Then you shall be the first to feel my wrath. Okay. So, we have to kill this thing. Use to purify the stagnant. Ah, okay. Okay. treasure it once more. More, I guess. Duty complete. Talk. My dreams all gone to dust. I'm powerless, powerless to protect my people, powerless to change anything. We are cowards, all of us. That which we do not understand instills fear within us, and so we lash out. In return, you sought to strike back at those who hurt you. You have done terrible things, and must be held to account for your crimes. But know that it is not too late to make amends. You still have a chance to atone. Your knowledge may yet be used for good. You need but find a new purpose, and I should be glad to help you look for it. With Alacra apprehended, it seems safe to say the danger to the Dwarfswood is past, and we owe it all to the two of you. This experience has taught me much and more, not least of all how powerless I was in the face of an external threat. If I am to protect the forest, I must needs spend less time with my head in the treetops and more with my feet on the ground. To that end, I shall strive to be a Bajal as Master Artova was, standing ready to journey to the ends of the world if needs be. Were it not for your shining example, I never would have found the courage to come to this decision. I cannot thank you enough. Master Arun, when the time comes for you to embark upon your journey, pray allow me to accompany you. It isn't safe to travel alone, you know this to be true. Besides, you need someone to keep a record of all your deeds, that they might be passed on to future generations. For all my bold words, I am still but a green sapling. Nevertheless, I would serve you faithfully as my grandfather once served Master Artova. I should be heartened to have your company, Ashiva. I shall endeavor to be a Pajal worthy of your respect. Thank you, Master Arun. I swear you will not be disappointed in me. Okay. Arunen, I shall escort Alakwa and place her in the wood dweller's care. Pray come and see us afterwards at Camp Tranquil. We would thank you properly. None. Okay. During the entire way back, Alakwa did not so much as favor us with a glance, but neither did she attempt to flee. I believe there is hope for her yet. Still such time as she finds a new purpose, I shall visit her cell as often as my duties allow. With the source of the taint banished, the Great One's warnings have ceased. We may rest easy for a time. Disaster has been averted thanks to you and Ashiva. We are eternally in your debt. You are kind for saying so, my lady, but I have done scarcely anything. All your gratitude should be reserved for Sweet. Allow me to thank you as well, Sweet. Had you not sought me out that day, I may never have found my true calling. Beginning today, I shall accompany Master Arun as he works to maintain peace and harmony within the Twelveswood. I know not where our journey will take us, but when next we meet, I shall stand before you a stronger woman. We had best be on our way. Fare you well on your own journey, Sweet. I look forward to seeing you again within the Twelveswood and without. Well, they pretty much exhausted everything I had intended to say. So I shall say but this. I mean to do my part as well. Together with my siblings, I shall work to preserve the harmony of the forest, protecting it from threats both within and without. As for you, Sweet of the White, with your newfound powers, pray continue employing our art for the betterment of the realm. May the light of succor and solace shine wheresoever you may go. Complete. This concludes the White Mage quests for Final Fantasy XIV Heavensward. In order to undertake the next series of quests, you must first meet the following requirements. You must have registered a product key for Final Fantasy XIV Stormblood to your service account. You must have completed the main scenario quest, The Far Age of Fate. Once you have done so, the next White Mage quest will be available from Raya Osenna. Now we have a new achievement, Seeing White 2. I guess it's a new title. There it is. Profile. Oh no. We do other. Achievements. Last 5 complete. Yes. The Pure White is the new title. Name. Pure White. Our new title. And now I want to equip this new gear. It's useless. Equip. Red Gear 2. Then I would say thank you for watching. I will see you the next time. Bye bye.